Greetings to our viewing and listening audience. We are the Youth Prayer Intercessors of the La Brea Seventh-day Adventist Church. Today we are presenting to you our prayer and prayers report. God is still God. Let us praise Him.
A little about us. Our team was launched on the 22nd of August 2015, and our mission is to reach and draw youth to Christ. So far, our efforts has been a zonal youth prayer conference, presentations of various prayer concerts, visitations, distributions of food, books, and tracts. But our participation in the South Caribbean Annual Conference prayer retreats has been our joy. That's at Belanger. We are guided by Ecclesiastes 12:1. Remember now the Creator in the days of thy youth, while the evil days come not, nor the years draw nigh, when thou shalt say, I have no pleasure in them.
Thanks very much for that lovely introduction, Kayla. But I have a question for you.
Okay, question.
What do you think about the level of spirituality of the youths in our churches today?
Well, from my observation, I believe, but wait, this sounds like a trick question. I am a youth, where is this going?
Don't worry. Let's just listen carefully to our fellow youths at La Brea as they present, God is still God. Let us praise Him.
Can you join me in prayer? Let's bow our eyes close. Dear Lord, thank you for this day, Lord. Thank you for getting us here to do the program, Lord. Help us as we do this program. May it be good, Lord. May it draw others to come and worship you too, Lord. Help us as we do the song service. May it be good, Lord. And protect us, guide us through the day, the rest of the day, Lord. Help us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Our first hymn will be 478, Sweet Hour of Prayer.
And the Omega, we come to worship you.
Transforming power of God's word, taken from Matthew chapter 9 verses 2 and Luke chapter 8 verses 48. The same power that Christ exercised when he walked visibly among men was in his word. It was by his word that Jesus healed diseases and cast out demons. By his word we are sealed. He stilled the sea and raised the dead, and the people bore witness in his word. And it was power. He spoke the word of God as he had spoken to all the prophets and teachers of the Old Testament. The whole Bible is a manifestation of Christ. The scriptures are to be received as God's word to us, not written merely, but spoken. When the afflicted ones came to Christ, he beheld not only those who asked for help, but all who throughout all the ages should come to him in like need and with like faith. When he said to the paralytic, "Son, be of good cheer, thy sins are forgiven." When he said to the woman of Capernaum, "Daughter, be of good comfort, thy faith had made thee whole, go in peace," he spoke to other afflicted, sin-burdened ones, who also sought his help. This same Jesus is knocking at the hearts, on the hearts of all of us today, all youths, Why not open up your hearts and let him come in? You will not regret it.
So, a couple of months ago, I fell off a banister about 15 feet and I had to go to the hospital because I had injured my spleen and my knee as well. And it was a trying time for me because although I had fallen a lot, this wasn't like any other fall because it hurt a lot more and it was really painful. So when I went to the hospital, they had first taken me up to test me and get some x-rays done. And while I was lying down in the bed, I was freezing cold. And I was there lying down and I was telling my mother I was freezing and I was asking her why I was freezing. She had no idea. So she said, say a prayer. And in my mind, I was vexed because sometimes it seems like that's the only answer they have for you. So I lie down and I said a prayer in my head. And suddenly I started feeling heat from a window that was so far away that, you know, you wouldn't even feel anything coming from it. And I started feeling the heat from it and I was like, Mommy, I'm feeling warm now. And she was happy to hear that because for somebody who is as spiritual as her, it was good to see some relief. And that's why every day after that, when I was in the hospital, I woke up and I said my prayers and I thank God for waking me up this morning, because I know that if I had done anything wrong, like walked too far, I would have bled out and died. So I prayed every day and every night to thank God for the small blessings. And I believe that with a little hope and a little prayer, anything could be possible. If God could save me from such a severe injury, then he could do it for you too.
Oh,
We really need to pray on, Kayla, because prayer moves mountains. Mm-hmm. Prayer is the answer to every problem in life. It puts us in tune with divine wisdom, which knows how to adjust everything perfectly. So often we do not pray in certain situations because to us, it's hopeless. But nothing is impossible with God. Nothing is so entangled that it cannot be remedied. No human relationship is too strained for God to bring about reconciliation and understanding. No habit is so deep that it cannot be overcome. No one is so weak that he cannot be strong. No mind is so dull that it cannot be made brilliant. And no one is so ill that he cannot be healed. Whatever we need, if we trust God, he will supply it. If anything is causing worry or anxiety, let us stop rehearsing difficulty and trust God for healing, love, and power.
God is still God, and he is still answering our prayers.
And working miracles too. Kayla, did you know that the hot air God sent to warm up Lejeune came through a sealed glass window?
What a miracle!
Imagine having such a close walk with God. But besides that, what do we need besides prayer to achieve that?
Well, the prayer of our parents and our church members, and also their guidance and support. I know we don't always see eye to eye with them on everything, but we just need to know that they are there for us, going the extra mile.
Ephesians chapter 6 verses 1 and 2 tell us, "Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor thy father and thy mother, which is the first commandment with promise."
So, Larissa, what else do you think we as youths need in these trying times?
We need to experience God's presence personally, and we need to be spirit-filled.
We need wisdom,
and we need boldness to share God's word.
Spirit of God, I joined the Youth Prayer Intercessors team about 4 years ago because I needed a closer walk with Jesus and to improve my prayer life. I was also excited about getting an opportunity to visit Cambodia because all who attended said it was very good. So I attended meetings and took part in the various prayer programs and visited another church. This was good. Then I got the chance to make my first visit to Cambodia, and I loved it very much. The prayer sessions were good and the prayer made me feel closer to Jesus. I loved the men's segment and I learned a lot. The next year, I had arranged to go back again and I woke up late and the maxi left me. I felt sad. But thanks to my dad, who decided to give me a chance, drove me straight up to Belanja and dropped me and went back home. I was very happy he had done so because, again, I had had a good time. And I want to encourage you all to come to Cambodia so you can also have a closer walk with Jesus and to improve your prayer life.
Book that you so interested by.
Well, one of them fellas had them just lend me this book entitled Message to Young People.
Oh, that book? I had a book somewhere home on my shelf now.
But it's very interesting. Listen, some of your topics are prayer or a stronghold, dangerous amusements, joy in religion, establishing the principles in youth, and true love. These are very interesting.
So, as a Christian child myself, what do you think we can pray for?
We can pray for a Christ-like character.
What else?
We can also pray for strength and joy too.
Yes, for the joy of the Lord is our strength. Very good. We need to overcome peer pressure.
But why are you asking me all this?
Because I was asked to pray in the program, and I'm so accustomed to praying for food, shelter, and clothes. I want to be different this time. Come on, let's pray.
All right.
Our Heavenly Father, we indeed thank you for providing us with food, clothing, and shelter, especially in these difficult times. I come bowing in your presence, dear Father, because as youths, we want to have a closer relationship with you. You said in your word that if we draw nigh to you, you will draw nigh to us. Help us to be more like you, that we may increase in wisdom and stature, and in your favor, that we would be holy examples to your fellow youths. I pray for strength and joy, strength to overcome peer pressure and the distractions the world offers, and joy in the Lord. The joy of the Lord is my strength. The Lord, when we are weak, or sad, or alone, your word assures us that your grace is sufficient and is made perfect in our weakness. Help us, Father, to be obedient to you and to your word. Psalms 119 verse 11 says, "Thy word have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against thee." Forgive us our sins, Heavenly Father. Recreate in us a clean heart, and renew a right spirit within us. These are the mercies we do ask. In your name, amen.
Amen.
Times and bad, you are on your throne. You are God.
pleasant good day to each and everyone. I greet you in the name of Jesus Christ. I hope and pray that everyone is doing fine at this time. I am here today to present you with a short message from God's Word. But before I start, let's pray. Dear Father, I ask as I go into your word that you will bless the persons viewing, that they will understand what I am saying. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. I will be presenting to you from the Word of God. Turn with me to your Bibles, to Psalms chapter 37. I will be dealing with the first 9 verses of the chapter. Now, something I am sure we all have done is fret, get angry, get upset. I mean, it's a natural human response to things. Fretting, wanting to get back at the person, taking measures into our own hands. But the Bible says in Psalms chapter 37, verse 1, fret not thyself because of evildoers, neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity. I know as a youth, almost everything people do, we do not agree with, we fret for. It gets us upset and angry, especially when they do it on purpose. Think about it. We fret almost all the time. And oftentimes, we like to take measures into our own hands without consulting God. And let me tell you something. That will never get you anywhere. It won't let you grow. And it will just mess up your blessings. You see, the second verse says that people that do evil deeds shall soon be cut down. Now, these are the words of the Lord, which are true and everlasting. So why should we fret? Why? The Bible proclaims that they shall soon be cut down, so fret not. Now, look with me to the Bible, and we are going to read verses 3, 4, and 5, the first line, and verse 7, 8, and 9, the first line of them. There is a message in there for you, and it reads, trust in the Lord, delight thyself also in the Lord, commit thy way unto the Lord, rest in the Lord, cease from anger, for evildoers shall be cut off. Now let's just read verse 9. For evildoers shall soon be cut off, but those that wait upon the Lord, they shall inherit the earth. Come on, the Bible is telling us today, if we wait upon the Lord, we shall inherit the earth. And the evildoers shall be what? They shall be cut down. So basically, the Bible is saying, do not fret, trust in the Lord, delight thyself in the Lord, commit thy ways unto the Lord, rest in the Lord, cease from anger, and we shall inherit the earth. Somebody give the Lord a praise today. Give the Lord a big shout out. Trust him, for he is faithful to his word. Now, during these times,
amen,
with all that is going on, surely we need to trust in God as youths and do not fret. I know that it seems and feels hard to do, but if we trust God, we can succeed with perseverance. Seeing how we have to stay home and we're not going to school, we can't go out and socialize as youths, we tend to be on our phones a lot. I am not saying do not use your phones or anything like that, but we should use our phones, especially during this time, to share God's message. Say and post something positive online. I know that every time an adult sees us on our phone, they automatically think that we are on WhatsApp or on some form of social media, but to the youth, do not fret. I know sometimes it feels annoying and you feel to fret, but trust God, trust God. And I want to challenge the youths, all the youths that are watching, I want to challenge the youths today. I want to challenge you to let's break the curve. That every time an adult sees us on our phone, it's not social media. Let's break the curve. Install our Bible app. Install Sister Ellen White, E.G. White writings. And let's read the Bible and share his word. We will be diligent and we will be proven to the adults that we are not always on social media. I challenge you to do that today. I challenge you to do it. And we can post quotes and verses share, and send to our friends. We have a lot of time on our hands, which we can use to become closer to the Creator Himself. But before I leave you today, let me pray for you. Dear kind and heavenly Father, I thank you for this day. I thank you for your love. I thank you for your grace. I thank you for your blessings you have bestowed on us. Lord, I thank you for the persons who are watching this right now. Lord, I ask that you would bless them in their homes, bless them in a mighty way. Touch them from the crown of their heads to the sole of their feet. Remove any unclean spirit from within their lives, that you will work in their lives and stay in their lives, dear God. Lord, I thank you for your blessings, dear Father. Lord, I ask that they would have learned something from what I have said before, previously, Father. That they shall not fret when people do them bad. They shall not worry and get angry, but trust in you, because you said in your word that we shall inherit the earth if we wait and trust in you, dear Father. So that I ask that they would remember that throughout the rest of the week, throughout the rest of the new month, and throughout the rest of the year 2020, dear Father. Lord, I ask that they will keep them faithful, keep them studying your word during this time. And for the youths, that they will not only be on their phones on social media, but take up the challenge and read the Bible, read Sister White's writings, that they will become diligent themselves, dear Father, so that when people ask them questions, that they will be able to answer properly and in faith, knowing that you are the answer to all their problems, dear Father. Lord, I ask that you will take charge, touch the persons who are being badly affected by this virus due to finances or whatever it be, Father. Lord, ask that you will intervene in each and every house right now, dear God. Lord, ask that your name will be praised in each and every house in Jesus' name, dear Father. Lord, ask that you will grant persons the finances to keep their houses good, dear Lord, that they will have enough to eat each and every day. Touch them in a mighty way. These and other mercies I ask. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen.
Kayla, I think we should take this opportunity to share some of our experiences from Camp Balandra. Now, as you remember, right, the first time that we went, it was because we were invited by our prayer coordinator, Sister Jade Wen.
Yeah.
And I recall it was only three of us, that'd be you, me, and Olivia, because it was introduced as a very senior-focused event, so the others weren't particularly keen on attending. And it was. We got there and there was only just not one other youth, right? There was a girl there. She ended up rooming with us and she was considering being baptized. And I have to say, it was a really great feeling being able to help her understand what that meant and why it was a decision that she needed to make, you know?
Yeah.
Another thing that was really great was all of the other folk who they embraced us. They were so glad to see us there, you know? It was inspiring because this meant that they could now invite their youths and help them on their walk with God, right?
Yeah.
Now, a lot of the presentations, they were brilliant, really thought-provoking, and they helped us come closer to God, to be more like Him. And then when we returned home to La Brea and we shared the experience with the other youth, they were so enthusiastic that we went from having three people to a whole maxi full the next year. It was just a really great feeling, you know, to not only be able to inspire other people from other churches, but also the youths here at home. Now, from these experiences combined with our presentation today, this should surely indicate to all that the God we serve is a loving and caring God. Jesus still sits in the throne of grace and is interceding on our behalf, and He is coming back to save us.
As youths, let us be encouraged to make Jesus Lord and Savior of our lives. Let us live according to His divine will and purpose for us.
Presently, the world is in crisis and fear is the order of the day. But God is still God. Let us praise Him.
Let's bow our eyes closed as we pray. Dear Father in heaven, we thank you for waking us up this morning and allowing us to see yet another day. Lord, we thank you for the opportunity that you have granted us to put on this program, that we are able to be examples for you and shine your light to the heart of men. Lord, we thank you for everything that you have done for us. We thank you that we are able to come before people like this, that we were able to spread your word, to praise you and to remind others that your name is God. You are God and you will be God long after this world is gone, that you are worthy to be praised now and forever. If there's anything we may have done that is unlike you, Lord, we ask that you would forgive us, that you would send your angels, and that you would send the blood of Jesus upon us to cover us, to help us resist temptation, that we would never commit these sins again, that we would never be unlike you, Lord. Lord, your word says that Satan is as a roaring lion seeking whom he may devour, and we see the calamities that he has wrought in our world. We see that he is coming and he is causing corruption and destruction and putting unease into the hearts of your creations, Lord, your people. Lord, we rebuke it in your name. We ask that you give us the strength and the courage, and that we would be able to stand strong for you whenever times are hard, when they are troubled. Lord, we ask that you would come and that you would encourage your youth, that they would be the ones to stand up for you, that we are the ones who would be able to share your name with others. Lord, we ask that you would give us the word, the ability to understand, the wisdom to speak, the eloquence that we need to be able to send your word out to the world, that others would hear and understand and appreciate and come to call you blessed now and forever. Lord, we ask that you would help us to continue to belong to you, and that we'd have the strength to stand for you when the time comes. In your name I pray. Amen.